understanding and your appreciation for what we're doing. This is jazz history, jazz appreciation history. I'm getting stuff tongue-tied. I don't know why I'm getting tongue tied. This is Jazz Appreciation Month. If we ain't here to perform for Jazz Appreciation Month, I'm gonna get it together. Yeah. So I'd like to let you know you're listening to me. Listen to Mr. Matthew Smythe on the road. Mr. Gordon Lane on the drum. I'm going to show you Bradford Hayes on the saxophone. And we are the Bradford Hayes Jazz Organ Trio. Now, the first composition we played was a composition by the late great Bobby Timmons, entitled Lonely. Did you enjoy that?
Yeah.
Look, the main thing is that you enjoy what you hear me. We feed you and you feed us back with applause. And we really appreciate it. We're gonna move on to a standard that everybody's pretty much familiar with, entitled Bye Bye Blackbird.
Thank you.
for 35 years and never learned the name. They said, you know, B.B. King had Lucille, why don't you name this song? I said, look, she got a name all of her own, talks the way she wants to talk. And there's something unique about this instrument. This instrument was made when I was 1 year old. In 1960. Oh, I just told myself. This instrument was made in 1960 when I was 1 year old. I did the research on it. And I bought it a long time ago from a gentleman named Bob Ackerman. I don't know if y'all remember that name. Bob used to play around. He had his house on McGuire Place in Irvington, and he sold horns out of it. And I lived right around the corner from him, never knew it until I was looking for an instrument. He's gone. He just passed away in the last year or so. But I remember those days so fondly. You know, I wanted to bring an organ trio because it's reminiscent of what I first heard when I came here in New Jersey in 1983. It was like Newark had organ trios all over the place, and I was the renegade. I was the guy said, okay, I'm getting the bass player, the piano, and the drum. I'm not doing that. And I started doing acoustic quartet and quintet. Sometimes I have a trumpet or trombone player with me. But I said, I'm going back to where we were because we need to go back to that a little bit. It's nothing like a great organ player. Master, great organ player. I do gigs in Brooklyn, and I met Matt in Brooklyn. And the drummer that works with us over there, George Bray, and he introduced me to Matt. And Matt sounded so great. I was trying to get Matt to come to New Jersey to play with me. The money was never right for him to come across the bridge and through the tunnel. That's right. So one day I was talking, we were doing a gig, and we're doing a gig. He says, you know, I'm from Hillside. I said, you're from Hillside? He said, yeah, I live in Linden now. I said, oh, thank God. He said, I can get this guy anytime I want to get him to come in Linden. Because he's right, and he's great, don't you think?
Oh, yeah.
This gentleman to my left right here, we go way back to when I had my acoustic quartet. It was a bass player named Harry Anderson. And Harry used to play with the Hopper Brothers, who went on to Philip Hopper. And we all became good friends, and I met him because they knew each other from years back down south, down in Louisiana. So I've been knowing this cat for about 30 years, 35 years now. This is Mr. Gordon Lane.
Yeah.
Now, myself, I was a music educator in Newark for 31 years. That's what I did. I taught music for 31 years. And I finally retired and got to do what I want to do all the time. But while I was teaching school, I was still working with this African drummer named Babatunde Alatunji. I worked with Bob for 15 years, the last 15 years of his life. And what he would do is he would, he always made accommodations for me. You know, I was a teacher. I told him, Bob, I'm not giving him my job. I'm sorry, I like to eat. So he said, okay, I'll work with you. And he came and he, when I got married in 1989, he was there. He came in the room to my wedding. I was like, wow. You know, we're supposed to do a gig at the University of Pittsburgh. He kept saying, Brad, I need you to do this gig. I said, Bob, I'm getting married that day. So he asked me where the church was. And when wife said, I do, we said, I do, it came down. He was sitting right there with the rest of the troop. So we played the bottom line one night a little later. And this young lady kept staring at me. She kept crying. She was looking at me and she was saying, did Bob ever tell you about his son, Kwame? And I said, no, who's Kwame? Well, Bob had a son named Kwame who went back to Nigeria to visit their family. He drowned while he was there. And she said, does he treat you different? I said, you know what? He does. He pays the other guys, he always gives me extra $150 in my check. And he always like this, when he's paying everybody, he gives it to me, and my eyes like this. And I said, he really does treat me a little different. She said, I said, why you say that? She said, because you look just like him. Oh. And he said, every time Baba sees you, he sees Kwame. Oh. And I said, he never said anything to me about it. I never mentioned it to him before he passed that I knew the story. So I asked the young lady, I said, why are you crying? She said, because he was my boyfriend. She was dating Kwame. She said, you look just like him. It's like looking at his reincarnation. And, you know, I've been so fortunate. We played the bottom line, we played the Village Gate, we played SOBs, we played all over the place. And I was a school teacher. So he said, okay, we're going to Chicago this weekend. Okay, he have an airline ticket in New York, I leave job, leave school, go get on a plane, fly to the weekend, come back Monday. Next weekend, he got a ticket for me to Houston. We going to Houston. So when it got so frequently when I came back to school, the other teachers were like, where did you go this weekend? I know you went somewhere. And that's the way it was, you know? I want you to do something for me. I'm not going to talk too much because you can't hear music. You didn't come to talk. Hear me talk. But I want you to visit www.bradfordhayes.com. That's my website. We do a lot of gigs around here in this area, and I'd love to see some of you at those gigs. We're doing downtown Westfield on July 9th. I can tell you that. Okay? So please come out there where it's probably in front of the turning point. That's usually our usual spot. Okay? All right, thank you. We're going to move on with some more music. Now we're going to do a composition that I wrote for my wife entitled Carolyn.
One, two, thank you.
$10 if you would like to take a copy, take Rapper home with you. That was written for my wife, Carolyn. In June, we've been married 35 years. And when you live the life of a teacher and a musician crossing paths, she's a very understanding lady. Let's do
Thank you. Thank you.
I recorded the Coaster on that CD right there. I got real close to him. He's one of the first jazz musicians I met when I first came to New Jersey, because he was from Newark. And he used to be teaching. He taught at the Newark School of the Arts on Clinton Avenue. Everybody know about Newark. And he said, come pick me up, take me to work. And I went and picked him up, took him to work. And then one day he said, we got to go down to the train station and pick up Jerry. I said, man, it's enough for me to be bringing you to work. Now we gotta go to Penn Station and pick up Jerry. So we go down to Penn Station, and this timid young lady gets in the car, and it's Jerry Allen. And Grayson was this great composer. He had real skills when it came to writing. And Jerry used to come to Newark to take composition classes with Grayson. And this is before anybody knew who she was. She was real little timid, and then she became this big star. Okay? But we're gonna play Grayson the Coaster.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. I see how you are going to be on the again, Matthew Smythe.
Yeah.
I'm glad to be. Thank you for coming out to see the show tonight. Thank you so much. Thank you for the thank you.